Hello and welcome back to another video. In today's video, we are going to talk about Barom's new collection called Crushed Metallic Foils. So before we start with the video, if you are new here, welcome to my channel. I post videos on nail art, nail extension, nail product reviews, anything and everything related to nails. So please consider subscribing to my channel. And if you are a subscribed user, welcome back and thank you for tuning in. So let's begin with the video. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, today we are going to review the new collection called Crushed Metallic Foils. So I got these polishes a couple of weeks ago. It's been a while, but here we are today. So this is the packaging. As you know, they have different types of packaging for each of their collection, and this is how they designed the packaging for the Crushed Metallic polishes. So these polishes are retailed at 149 rupees right now, and you can check it out on their website. And I'll put all the links in the description box. So now we are going to see each polishes and then we will swatch them and we will see how they look. So the first polish from the collection is this one. This polish is named as Angel Aura and it's a 8 ml bottle, and as you can see, it says silver metallic foils crushed into a transparent base. So here it is, that's how it looks from the bottle. And now let's swatch. For the swatches, I have my natural nails ready. After a long time, I removed all the extensions and I'm going to swatch it on my natural nails. So as you can see, application is really smooth, but if you notice, this polish is not opaque. It's just a transparent polish with the foils crushed into it. So you are not going to get a really opaque finish with this polish. You may want to go for like 4 to 5 layers of application, then you may get that like thick opaque finish. So if you are planning to use this as a base color for your nails, then I don't think this will be like perfect for you, but we will still swatch it as it is, and then later I will show you how this is gonna look on other base colors. So keep watching. The second polish from the collection is named as Champagne Fizz. As the name says, it's a beautiful golden polish, and just as the previous one, this polish is also translucent with a yellowish base color. So if you wanted to use it as a single polish on your nails, then obviously, as I said earlier, we may want to go for like 4 to 5 layers of application, and then the drying time is going to be like approximately an hour time. So otherwise it will not dry unless you give like enough time gap between each layers. So better we use it as a top coat. Anyways, these polishes are really stunning as a top coat. I'm gonna show you that towards the end of this video. So this is the first coat. Now let's see the second coat. So for the second coat, I tried a different method. So you know how we do the builder gel application, right? So similarly, I picked a lot of product on the brush, and then I am just trying to keep more flakies onto my nail surface so that I can get that opacity in the second layer of application. So this is not the ideal way of applying it, but I just wanted to show you how you can get that really opaque finish so that you know how it's gonna look after applying like 3-4 layers. So this is that thick application. Now you can see how it looks on the nails. So this is how you are going to see it when you do 4 or 5 layers of application of this particular polish. The third polish from the collection is named as Dazzled Affair, and as you can see on the screen, it's a beautiful purple crushed metallic foil nail polish. And again, just as the other two polishes, this one is also semi-transparent, and I'm just going to quickly show you how it looks on the nails, and I'm going to use the same techniques that I was using in the previous polish application so that you get an idea how that it's gonna look like. So this particular collection has 7 different colors available. So I have all 7 colors here. So I'm going to show you all of them. If you wanted to buy it, you can buy it as a set, or you can buy your preferred colors. And this video is not sponsored by Barom's. I purchased these polishes. I like all their new collection. So that's the reason I am purchasing it, and I'm making videos and I'm sharing with you guys. So I'm in no way associated with Barom's. So I just wanted to make it clear here. The next polish from the collection is named as Good Vibe. So this is a green metallic foil collection. So if you ask me, I think it's between yellow and green. It's not completely green, it's not completely yellow. So it's in between. Again, consistency, application, texture, everything is same as the other polishes that we have just seen. So quickly applying it onto my natural nails, and at the end of this clip I'm going to show you how it looked on my extensions. I applied like 4 or 5 layers when I was like taking some pictures for my Instagram on my extension. So it looked really stunning, but it took a long time to dry. So that is another thing. Some people are allergic to the smell of nail polishes. So this one is not like too strong. There is a slight smell, but it's not too strong. So that is also there. So this is how it looked on my extensions. So the next polish is named as Ocean Eye. In their website they call it as a carbon black polish, and it looks slightly different in the pictures of their website, but in actual it looks more of like a bronze color shade. That's what I feel. After applying it, it looks really beautiful, and I really liked all of these collections. So I think I will prefer it as a top coat rather than using it as it is as a polish. So now I'm trying to get that opacity. So then at last I'm going to show you how this one looks with like a thick layer of application. So that's how it looked. It took a lot of time to dry, but it looks stunning on my nails though. Lastly, we have Pretty in Pink. So this is the last shade from the collection. It's a beautiful pink polish, and it looked really stunning, just like all other polishes from this collection. But one thing that I have noticed is that this Pretty in Pink and the Dazzle Affairs, they look more of a similar kind when you apply it in the bottle. If you like keep it next to each other, the Dazzle Affair is like a little more darker pink than this one, but when you apply it, it's more of like a similar kind of finish and color and everything. So here is a comparison. On the middle finger it's Pretty in Pink, and on the index finger it's a Dazzle Affair. So you can't really find a difference, but there is a difference. It's like very slight difference. So that's what I wanted to say. So here is the two coat final look. So it's like more of a similar one. So with that, we have done with the individual swatching. Now let's see these polishes as a top coat on different colors. For that, I have a swatch wheel ready with all these colors, and now I'm going to apply those crushed flaky polishes as a top coat. So here I'm not going to talk much, you just watch and see how these polishes are going to work as a top coat. So I'm going to apply it on different colors, and then you can see how it looks. Frankly speaking, after the swatches as a top coat, I fell in love with these polishes, and I really loved the way it looked, and after the top coat they were like so perfect. So what do you guys think? You like it as a top coat, or you like it as like a normal polish on your nails? So let me know in the comment section. So with this, I am summarizing this video for today. I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you like it, don't forget to like, share, comment, all those good things, and I'll see you soon on my next video. Until then, stay safe, stay happy. Thank you for watching.